Hello and welcome, my name is Jan. In this video I will show you how you can create 3D lines with visual scripting in Allplan 2019. If you want to watch more videos about visual scripting, then you can click on the right side of this video and you will see the playlist about visual scripting. To create 3D lines, you have to go to the geometry objects. The first I will show you is the 3D arc. You click on it and you drag it in the window. And I will just leave it like this. The radius, for example, we can make it a bit bigger. 5. Start angle is 0, the end angle is 90. And now you just have to click on run. And you can see how it looks like. You can also change now the angle, for example, 120. And then getting bigger. You can also change the settings in the node script and type in here 150 degree. And again, it changed. So the next thing is normally the 3D spline. I don't know how it works at the moment, so that's why I will just leave it like this. The next one is the 3D circle. And we have again the center point, the radius, make it a bit bigger again, 2 meter. And I just click on run. What we can do now is change the vector. Then the circle rotates. For example, I type in 2. Then the axis should change. Yes. Table 1. The next one is the 3D line, which is clear, I would say. Yeah, here the start point 000 again and end point. You can say for now, for example, 10 meter. Oh. Then you just click on run and it creates the line. You can also, for example, change the line and you just say not x10 but x10 and z5. Then it goes up like this. The next one is the 3D B-spline, created by points. You get it, and you can change here the degree. And you need points. So that means when you click on run, there will be no B-spline. You just get the 3D points. This will be the start point. This will be the endpoint. We start again at 0. And we go to x5. We click on run. You can see here's the spline. By now it's just a straight line, but when we create a third point and we say x7 and y is 8, and I connect it with the B-spline, click on run, and you see that the spline changed. You can also create a fourth point. And let's say this time it's x10 and y is 9. Connect it again, click on run, and it's changing. As you can see, the spline is always following the last point you just created. You can't say, I want the other point in here. The spline will just go back like this. So it's impossible. I can show you. For example, two. I connect it and now it will go back like this. That's what you have to know when you create B-splines. The next one is the end polygon. We have again the center point, the radius, make it bigger, 5, inner radius. Then you can say corner point, count. I click on run. So it says here it has 6 corners. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And you can also say now, okay, I want 10, or just 4, 5. Okay, you can also change it again here if you want. So the next one is the 3D plane by points. It just has 3 points, but the symbol says it has 4 corners. And I don't know why, but you can't create a 4th point. It's just like this. The next one is the 3D plane by vector, placement point, normal vector, 001. Now you click on run and it will look like this. With the vector, you can change the direction of the plane. For example, x5 or y7, and you can see it's rotating. You already should know what the point is. You can't see the point in the window, but the point is there. The next one is the 3D polygon. By now, I also don't know how you can change the settings, because as you can see, you can't put anything inside. But when you click on run, it's creating something. It's the same thing with the 3D polyline. You can't change anything in here. But when you click on run, create something again. The next and the last one is the 3D spline. Click on run. And here you can see that the spline is created. And I can change here something. Now I want to show you how you can create a pipe. At first you need again the BP spline and you need some points. 1, 2, 3, 4. I will get 4 points. Start point. Now I just type in 2. Here it's 4, 7. Here it's 10, 8. I created with the BP spline. Click on run. Now you can see how this plane looks like. Next, I have to create a path. That's this one here. Create a 3D path. I connect the BP spline with the path. Nothing will happen by now. But when you get now the pipe, you connect the path with the pipe and you just say, I want a radius of 1 meter, and I click on run and you will see now that the pipe is created. and change again the settings here as well. For example, I take now 3 meter. You can also create a rectangle from a path. You click on it, drag it in the window, and you connect the spline with the path. Then we can say length, width, click on run. And you can see that the rectangle is created. If you want, you can also change the settings again. So for example, 1 meter, 2 meter. And I don't want a placement point on the left side, but on the in the middle, for example. And I can say again where I want to have the rectangle. But now it starts here, but now you can say I want the middle. You can also change the position in the Y direction. So it's not in front, but in the middle. I will just leave it like this so that the rectangle is in the center of the line. I think that's it for now. If you have any questions, then write a comment. Please like the video and subscribe to my channel. See you next time.